Hello. Today I want to talk about major scales. Now, major scales is a series of fixed intervals. Now, intervals is the distance between your notes or between your fingers. Yeah. So far we've seen tones and semitones, and that's what major scales use. The fixed interval is always the same. So you have two tones and a semitone. Three tones and a semitone. So, I'll quickly show you. We'll take A major. So, I start on the lowest A on the string. A. A tone away is B. Now, BC is a natural semitone, but I need the tone, so now I end up on C sharp. And D is that semitone. So as you can see, we've just had two tones and a semitone. Now, for the next tone, I'm going to move my finger. I'm going to lift it up and place it on the next string. I needed E. From D to E was a tone. Another tone. A third tone. And a semitone. So the notes I just played is E, F sharp, G sharp, and A. Now this is A, and the first note we played was A. Yeah? That is a scale. It's a series of seven notes, and then we end up back on the first note. So altogether, it's eight notes. Now, you can put one octave on top of the next octave. So we just played one octave. Now if you continue, the next octave starts on that fourth finger, was A. And the next open string also is A. So now you can choose. You can start either from the fourth finger or from the open string. Let's start from the fourth finger because that's where we ended. I need a tone between 4 and 1, so I just move my first finger to the next string. I need another tone. So now that was C sharp, and now we're on D, that was a semitone. Now we need three tones. Tone. Again, move first finger to the next string. Tone. And last tone. And we finish again, as always, on a semitone. And we're back on A. Yeah. So that is what the scale is. It's two tones, a semitone, three tones, a semitone. Repeated over and over again. Now, you can start a scale on every single letter of the scale, so A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. You can also start it on every single letter with a sharp, so A sharp, B sharp, C sharp, and so on, and with the flats, A flat, B flat, C flat, and so on. So essentially, you're looking at a possibility of 3 times 7, so 21 different scales. Now that seems an awful lot, but because you only have four fingers on an instrument, right? And you have a fixed pattern, it means that there's only four different scales possible if you look at it from a physical point of view. You can either have 1 and 2 against each other, 2 and 3 against each other, 3 and 4 against each other, or nothing against each other. And every single scale starting on the first finger will have the third and the fourth finger against each other. Yeah? Every single scale starting on the second finger will have the semitone between 4 and 1, which means there's no fingers against each other. The one starting on the third finger will have 1 and 2 against each other, and the octave starting on the fourth finger or the open string will have 2 and 3 against each other. And essentially with all these scales you're going to learn, all these major scales, yeah, this is just for the major scales, this is all you need to know. Yeah, there's only four possibilities. So I'll repeat, if your scale starts on the first finger, you will have the third and the fourth finger against each other for two strings. Yeah? For that one octave. If your octave starts on the second finger, you You will have no fingers against each other. You will have low first finger on the next string every single time. If your octave starts on the third finger, you will have the first and second finger against each other. And finally, if an octave starts on the fourth finger or the open string, you will have the second and third finger against each other. And now there's 21 potential possible scales that we were talking about have just been reduced to 4 possibilities. Yeah. And I would suggest you just memorize this. Yeah. First finger, then 3 and 4 are against each other. Second finger, nothing against each other. Third finger as the first note of the scale, then you're going to have 1 and 2, and the fourth finger or the open string, 2 and 3. Now I've said it 3 times, please write it down and study it, because this will make learning scales ridiculously easy. My first introduction to the left hand was 4 finger patterns, right? And this is why. Even your minor scales are going to follow a similar structure, except for it's a lot more complicated than this one. So memorize this, what I just told you, and then the rest will start making sense very quickly. Good luck with scales, and I'll make another video to explain how to practice a scale, how to learn it. Yeah, good luck, and I'll see you there. Bye.